I am 1/4 Ojibwe. My grandmother, she's full. So I grew up going to Native American education in LAUSD, and they really emphasized like the natural relationship, and that was kind of like the beginning. I would do really long walks at a young age, probably like 5th or 6th grade, like through the forest. And I had like a feeling of either I was being seen by the plants around me, or that something was like trying to speak to me. I would spend a long time out there and just like listening to the wind and just like really laying there and just being still. And I think I really carried that feeling with me. It really started my attraction to plants. It feels like communication, almost like unspoken communication. Hi, my name is Melina Lydia. I actually just graduated from UCSC. Go banana slugs. I was a plant science and literature major, so I'm really big on science communication. I'm really into ethnobotany and kind of like molecular labs right now. I currently work as a molecular lab technician in the Meyer lab and working with CalEDNA. And hopefully I would love to get my PhD and do a lot of plant research in the future. Today we are looking for California Huckleberry. So often when foraging, people get really excited when they just see any type of berry in general. And this is actually a great example of what to do when you encounter a berry and if you just want to know what it is or you're in your beginning stages of identifying. So for example, this is Black American nightshade. It can sometimes be mistaken for huckleberries or just like evergreen huckleberries because they're just the same like dark blue berry. Here it's like white flowers, and then these are kind of like where the berries would come off, but these are way different from the huckleberries, as well as you can tell from the leaves coming out in whorls instead of alternate. That's another indication that it's not a huckleberry. So this little cute guy, these little berries are right here, are California huckleberries. They're really easy to identify from their alternate leaf pattern. Their leaves are also slightly serrated and really small. This seems like about like 1 inch long and probably less than a half of an inch, maybe a quarter of an inch wide. These guys are actually coastal lovers. You'll find them along the redwood belt. They actually like moist to slightly dry soils, and with more fog from the ocean, they'll actually have a higher yield in berries. The leaves have actually been taken and covered in sugar and given to women after childbirth to help them gather their strength again. The leaves and berries are both really high in vitamin C, and the twig tea has been said to like cleanse the body of toxins and bacteria and carry them out. But regular twig tea drinkers have actually said you should drink this in moderation and not all the time. They can also be mushed up, dried. A lot of the times they can just be eaten. So many people love to make huckleberry pies. What makes them different from a blueberry is that when you cut a blueberry in half, it's actually pale in the middle, and huckleberries have more of like a deep blue, deep red color and juice. So these are the younger berries. You can see some of them are green and they haven't turned that dark, deep color yet. But the more mature ones, trying to find one that doesn't have spiderweb on it, these ones right here are definitely more plump and a darker color. Because I never really had anyone to like tell me verbally any information or like how to identify things. I really just kind of, with my own curiosity, like sought out books and other identification tools to help me forage. Books that kind of like talk about ethnobotany and about like native uses, and also just like edible and medicinal uses can really help just like broaden your perspective on ways that we can use plants. It helps eliminate plant blindness. All of these books, well, most of them I checked out from like a public library. And so there's so many resources out there that can help you like get into foraging and just like they helped me, and then also help deepen like your relationship and like understanding of like what they've done for humans for so long and like what they can continue to do in the future.